Hi, I'm Rachel Kelmartin, and I'm a lab technician with George Mason University's Freshwater Fish Lab. And today I'm going to show you how to identify the larval fish that you all will be pulling from the debris for us. So your end product from last time is going to be this little vial of preserved fish and ethanol. From this little vial, you end up dumping it in a small dish where you have all of your fish to be identified. They're all in water because ethanol dries up real fast, and you don't want your fish to dry up. If they dry up, they become unidentifiable. Because your fish are so small, millimeters in size, they can be anywhere from 2 to 10 millimeters at hatching size, which is really small. Not microscopic, but not easy to see with the naked eye. You need a high-powered microscope. So this is our Leica. It's a stereo microscope. It just has a much better power to it and higher image quality so that you can see all the details of the fish that you need to see to identify them. I've pulled 4 larvae for you guys today. All of these are pre-identified. I know what they are, but I think they represent all the 4 different characteristics that we really look for in the fish. So here's 3 of our smaller ones, and you can really see how small they are because I have a ruler right here. Each distance between the 2 bars, that's 1 millimeter. Size is a really important characteristic. Depending on the family and even depending on the species, they all hatch at different sizes. So for example, this guy right here is a white perch. So his hatching size, he's only maybe hours old. He's not even 4 millimeters, he's 3 and some change. Using the size and also the appearance of a yolk sac or absence even will help us determine how old they are and can help us determine what species they are due to their life cycle. So he has a yolk sac right here. It's what ichthyoplankton use before they even have a mouth. As you can see, he doesn't have a mouth. He has a little teensy head, and then his yolk sac, that's where he gets all of his nutrients from. They absorb it much like a chicken and an egg absorbs the yolk sac before it's born. By comparison, we have this guy who's about 7 days old. He's a completely different fish. He's not a white perch. But as you can see, he's so big, he barely even fits under the microscope. He doesn't have a yolk sac. He has his mouth, and he's big enough to eat on his own. He'll eat plankton, anything that'll fit in his mouth that's nutritious. So one of the most important is the location of the vent. So your vent is the opening at the end of the digestive and reproductive tract. His vent is going to be at the very end of his yolk sac, right there. This white perch at the top, the end of his vent is right in the center of his body. You can see what would be his intestine / reproductive tract, that little pale white line going down his yolk sac all the way to the end. So that's what you look for. So once you have the vent located down and you can identify to family, then we can go a little more specific. We can start with Myomors. Myomors are your second most important identifier. Myomor is a V-shaped muscle fiber. It's what makes up your muscles, and because these fish are so small, it is their muscles. So you can see it really well in this little white perch right here. All these little Vs, those are little muscles. And what you do is you count the Vs before and after the vent. Each species has a very specific count. They're all different. So like a white perch has a Myomor count before its vent of 9 to 11 and after its vent of 9 to 11. And you can compare that with this guy, who's a gizzard shad. His pre-count is like 39, and his post-count is maybe 7. So a not as reliable, but still very important identifier that you want to look for are chromatophores. Chromatophores are literally just spots of pigments on the larval fish. So you can see in this goldfish, he has chromatophores all over the place. That's all the black that you see, even all the little dots. It's not reliable because the ethanol that you preserve these fish in can bleach out the chromatophores and make the fish all white, but it is helpful. So using the identifiers I described to you in this video, we will identify your ichthyoplankton as specifically as possible and send the information back to you so you can complete your study.